Welcome to Confession. In this murder mystery performance, you shall be playing my role alongside me, being my eyes and ears. So stay alert, keep an eye out for clues. You will have a chance to bring justice in. But until then, sit back and watch us.
You're a liar. I'm
innocent.
You
did it.
Confess.
You did it.
I am innocent.
You're
a liar.
I'm
lying. You did it. You're
a liar.
I'm innocent.
You're a liar.
Good morning, Thomas Rotherham College. Welcome back to another day here in paradise. Now, I do have to regretfully inform of the tragic passing of our very own Mary Menken. Now, I'm sure a lot of you have questions. However, for three of you, you'll be the ones being asked the questions. A detective is coming in to interview said three people, so stay calm and answer honestly. Because of this terrible, terrible incident, sausage rolls are now half price. So, get them while they're hot. The time is 8:05. This is Monday the 8th. Thank you for listening. One of you three is directly responsible for the death. No. The murder of Mary. Now, I'll be conducting a series of questions for you three to discover your involvement with the crime. I'll be starting with Judith Conte. So if you'd like to step into the isolated room, we'll get things started. Morning, Judith. Now, would
Judy.
You...
Judy. My friends call me Judy.
Totally understand. So, Judith, would you please care to state your relationship to the deceased?
Well, my relationship with Mary was quite complicated, as we were classed as enemies.
Enemies? Do go on.
It's quite of a long story, so I suggest you take a seat. Anyways, it all started over the summer when a rumour was going around that a new girl was going to join my school. Well, technically, I don't run the school, but I'm head. So, in a blink of an eye, all the boys started elevating her. Which was odd, since female specimens don't really get recognition except for me, so I decided to conduct some research into her, and I came to find out her mother died at childbirth. How sad. That's besides the point. Every year we have cheer tryouts where pathetic little females have the opportunity to either join the team or try and become cheer captain, which has never been successful since I've been cheer captain 3 years in a row. However, Mary came worming her way in, stumbling along, and some way, somehow, detective, she managed to dethrone me. It gets worse. This B-I-T CH of a female stole my boyfriend! Ew. That was it. I knew I had to make her disappear or get rid of her. You know, teenage female girl things.
And what did this teenage, you know, girl things entail?
It's not a job.
Stay focused!
So I poured Mary a drink, because obviously I knew she was going to be in such discomfort, and I led her to the position where she would see my friend Lee and Joe upstairs and find me cheating. I gave her a drink to comfort her, and some way, somehow, detective, she became unconscious and blacked out. Since I am the best civilian with amazing morals, I placed her gently into the bedroom. And that was the last I have seen of Mary Menken.
Thank you, whatever that was. Send the next one in. Morning, Gabriella.
Morning, Mr. Menken.
Now, this is all for a bit of formality. You don't need to worry. So, even though I know, state your relationship and state your name for the case.
Gabriella Brown.
And as I said, state your relationship to the to Mary.
Well, me and Mary have been best friends for as long as I can remember, really. Actually, let me show you. I first met Mary at Agatwood Park, where I found her sat by herself alone on a bench. At first, she was a little bit resistant to becoming friends with me, but after a while we started talking and I found out that her mother had died at childbirth, which was really sad. Anyway, I went to comfort her as I came into the struggle as the same thing happened to my mother. And from then on, we've been together ever since.
So does that mean you two are at the party together?
Not exactly. You see, Detective, I arrived at the party a little bit late. So I went around asking if people had seen Mary. Hey guys, do you know where Mary is?
She's behind you!
Come on guys, I can't hear you.
She's behind you!
Okay. Anyway, Detective, somebody said that they saw her go upstairs with Judy, so I went to investigate. And as I was walking up the stairs, I heard this banging on a door. So I went to open it. And there she was.
Come on, up you go.
So, did anything seem off with Mary at the time?
No. She seemed perfectly fine.
And what time did you two leave?
Well, I left at around 10:30, but I did see her go towards Joe before I left.
Huh. Interesting. Send Joe in. State your name for the case.
There must be some sort of mistake here.
State your name.
You know me, I dated your daughter for 2 years.
Just say your name.
I'm not the one hiding something, am I, Michael?
I won't ask you again. State your name for the case.
She's gone. Let her go.
State your fucking name! You don't have to threaten me! Isn't this on record? I'm a lawyer! I am quite possibly the best detective Vegas Crown has seen, and I will not let some low-life boyfriend get away with killing my daughter. You do not deserve a lawyer! Gabriella, she could hurt a fly. And Judith, she couldn't give a shit about Mary.
You think you know Gabriella? She was always spreading lies about Mary's life.
But she cared for Mary when she was intoxicated.
Well, Gabriella was always spreading rumours behind her back, her so-called best friend.
Judy, don't think her life is so perfect. Let's just say her mother is, well, she's not going to be talking to her anytime soon.
Oh, look at you being useful for once. You may go now.
This prompted Judith to look into your family's past. She was always sly, so that's why I broke up with her. Me and Mary were doing great till the night of the party. So drunk I wasn't thinking straight. After I found her in the cupboard, we both left and cut through the woods home.
You and I both know she didn't come home that day.
Things got heated and an argument broke out between us two. To be perfectly honest, I wasn't listening to her. It was like this ringing in my ear. I just needed to get everything off my chest. It's almost as if she was silent and expressionless. Come on, Mary, this night's been well. Eventful. No, you've got it all wrong. Why would I cheat on you? I love you, man. I think she was some friend of Judy's. She was telling me about how you and Gabriella are always pushing me away. No, but you are, though. You never speak to me. It's all your fault this has happened. You can't trust Judy, but you can't see that. You need to get out of your fantasy land. Wake up!
You didn't. Did you?
I did. Mary, I can't believe you made me do that. I sometimes just wish you and Judy would disappear.
So then, what? Where? What happened after?
It was all a blur. I'm sorry. But just so you know, Detective, I always loved your daughter. I wasn't myself that night. I was angry at the world, and unfortunately, she was mine. Say something!
Joe, go get the others. I figured out who killed my daughter. What you three have told me is correct.
There can only be one true killer.
The times, the locations, the motivations, it all lines up. Mary was found dead the night after the party. She was found with multiple scratches, bruises, and major trauma to her skull. Now, later, you three will complete a fingerprint analysis test to determine whose prints were on her body. The two of you, I believe there is salvation, and maybe even warmth when this mess clears. Although, for one of you, the darkest pit of hell has opened to swallow you whole, so don't keep the devil waiting.
Hi everyone, hope you're enjoying our show, Confession.
Sorry to interrupt the four things.
But we wanted to do things a little differently.
In the spirit of the whodunit genre, we thought we'd let you guys decide who did it. So,
who killed Mary?
Would you like to raise your hands if you thought it was Judith?
Would you like to raise your hands if you think it was Gabriella?
Oh, too many. Give me a second, guys.
Or would you like to raise your hands if you think it was Joe?
Come on, guys.
Yeah.
Thank you, guys.
The value consensus says that you guys think Gabriella was the true killer, so
I am offended, guys.
Let's get back to the performance and uncover the truth.
Thank you for completing the fingerprint test. Now, I can confirm that all of your prints were on her body. Each and every one of you is responsible for her death. But only one of you took the life of my daughter away. Heed the warning I give. I believe I figured it out. I've been blinded by this hatred. I must make peace with the storm that thrashes in my brain. I will give the devil one final chance to confess. Wish they be damned for all time.
Confess.
So be it. Mary was killed by the person that was closest to her, her true heart. Joe Davis what? Killed my daughter. Now,
I can really confess. I mean, look at that.
I'm sorry. I can't believe you thought it was Joe. Oh, Detective, it wasn't Joe. It was me. I killed Mary. I killed my best friend and your precious daughter.
Now, would you look at that? Who knew a rat could be a murderer? I told you I didn't do a detective. What a waste of my time.
Why would you kill her? She was your best friend. She loved you.
I wanted to get back at the man who wrongly framed my dad. Everything fell into place. This man's world was brightened by his daughter. So if I were to remove that guiding light, he can't see. His moral compass and judgment spirals off. He snapped at Joe, like I anticipated. We all knew Joe was the most likely suspect. And you, detective, fell right into my trap! The party was the perfect setting. Throw everybody off! And all I had to do was spark the flame to burn her down. I was the one who encouraged Mary to get with Joe. I just forgot to mention that he was with poor widow Judy.
You low-life peasant! And to think I even let you breathe the same air as me or to even be in the same presence as me. And from now on, you call me Judith, not Judy. Moon!
And the best part about it, I didn't care about your daughter. 16 years ago, you framed my dad for a crime you know he didn't commit. And ever since then, I have devoted my life to destroying everything you love.
Guys, have you guys seen Gabriella's parents' section?
This can't be real.
Oh, give me that.
Oh my god. I'm gonna be sick.
What? You're my daughter?
So that means I killed my sister?
Ah, Mary, I can't believe you made me do that. Sometimes it's just you and Gabrielle disappear.
Thank you everyone so much for watching Confession. Now, who got it right? I saw a lot of people get excited when I said Joe did it, so you all got absolutely duped on that. Now, so we are doing a small Q&A session where we have to hand out some sheets. However, if some of you are brave, you can ask us live questions and we'll promise to try and give a good answer and not panic. So we'll let you complete this for a bit, then we'll try and answer the questions as best we can.
Might not have
a lot. Can't promise anything more.
Thank you. Thanks. It was like playing drum teacher. I like Judy. She's like, she reminds me of Maddie from that.